Hey guys, today I'm going to show you how I got 14 dates in just 4 hours work on Tinder. I'm going to show you every step along the way of how I built the profile. I'm going to show you examples of my profile and other profiles that are getting similar results so you can copy exactly what I did and get exactly the same result yourself. Now, before I started working on my profile, I did a little bit of research. I hung out with some female friends. I watched them using Tinder. I actually filmed them using Tinder. I asked them questions about why they made certain decisions so I could get an insight into, you know, what women were doing so I could learn to hack that process. And I learned a couple of really interesting things. First of all, women will swipe left just as quickly as men, but they will take 10 times longer to swipe right than men. So that means that women are being a lot more cautious about who they swipe right to. They're just as quickly to dismiss you. But they're really gonna like look carefully at your profile, look through all your photos, look through what you've written in your profile before they'll swipe right. And if anything you do there turns them off, you're out of there. You've lost your chance. The second thing I learned is that women get a match on almost every man they swipe right to. So you know that experience that guys have when we we go into Tinder, we're like, swipe right, swipe right, swipe right. Ooh, a match. swipe right, left, 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 right, left. You know, we might get a match, you know, like luckily just like that, maybe two. But women, it's like swipe right, ooh, match, swipe right, ooh, match, swipe right, ooh, match. It's that consistent for them. And as a result, it brings me on to the third important thing that I learned. And this is really important for you to know. Women get asked out on dates about 5 times a day on Tinder. So here's the thing, you have massive amounts of competition. There's lots of guys matching with every girl you like, and so you need to compete with them. Now that's the bad news. The good news is that they're actually really bad competition, and if you just employ a couple of really great strategies, it's easy to stand out from the crowd in such a way that she's gonna wanna match with you, she's gonna wanna talk to you, and she's gonna wanna go on a date with you, and that is what I'm gonna show you today. Now, when it comes to an order of importance on your Tinder profile, there's three major things that women are going to look at. The very first thing, the very most important thing in your profile is your profile photo. Now I'm going to go into some details today about, you know, how to create a perfect photo, what constitutes a photo women are going to want to, you know, swipe right to. But if your photo's no good, bam, left straight away. So that photo counts. The second thing then, if you've got a good photo, what women do is they look straight and see what's written in your profile to see if there's anything there that can give them a hint as to what kind of guy you are. And if that passes muster, then they'll go and start to swipe through the rest of your photos and have a little bit of a closer look before they bother to swipe right. So you're going to have a really great profile photo and a really great profile write-up and good photos, you know, in your gallery to get women to want to match with you. And so a lot of guys who aren't getting matches, I'm going to tell you what, the biggest mistake they're making is a terrible profile photo. If you've got a terrible profile photo, there's nothing that you can do. So I'm going to give you some tips about how to get a better one. Or if you can't get good photos, how to kind of, a couple of little cheats you can use along the way to get matches regardless of that. So stay tuned, guys. So the very first profile example that I put up is this photo here that you can see. Now, there's a couple of things wrong with this photo, and I did a test. I swiped right on 100 women, and I wanted to see how many of those first 100, just complete random swipes, would match with me. And what I discovered was 4. 4 out of 100, 4% would actually match with me. Now, there's a lot of things wrong with this photo. The fact that it's a terrible quality photo is a big one. But also, one that plays a role is I look like a complete short ass here. And you know, I'm not that short. I'm average height of like 5'9", but my friend is a giant. And so standing next to him, I just look like a short ass. The only reason I think I got those 4% of matches is because plenty of women have a thing for firemen, and I was dressed up like a fireman for this party, so that was going to be a win for me. But I knew that I could improve it. So what I did was I actually went and I started testing a lot of different profiles. I tested a lot of different styles of photos. I went out with a couple of friends who did like photos for me with a camera, some with a phone, it didn't really matter, just lots of different kinds of photos with puppies, photos of my face, photos of me doing an activity, all different things. I tried lots of different profile write-ups and, I actually discovered like a number of things that really made a big difference. And I use 25 factors that you want to have in every profile. And so what you can see up here now is a profile that I put up. that worked really well. This was kind of the culmination of a little bit of my research. This is my second try. And so there are a couple of things that I did. Those included, first of all, I had a really high quality picture of my face. That was the first thing girls could see. Secondly, I had a lengthy description of myself, and I included humor. So there was funniness, there was humor and like playfulness in my description. So when they wanted to know what my personality was like, they could see it written there in what I wrote. And if you can't read what I wrote, if you think my profile is tight, then just swipe right. Now you know why I'm not a rapper. I'm a life coach who loves intellectual conversation and chocolate ice cream orgies. I love my job and my life, and I've been known to overindulge in electronic gadgets I don't really need. So I'm showing some personality there, and women want to see personality. And lastly, you know, it's I'm not looking straight at the camera, and I'm smirking, but haven't got a full-on smile. Now, these are just some of the factors that play a really big role in having a profile picture that just converts. When I put this profile to test and, you know, swipe right on a random 100 women, instead of getting 4 matches, I was getting 21 matches. And now, if you do your maths, that's more than 5 times better results because I made those changes. Now, I know that, the profile photo played a large role, but also what I wrote played a role. And so, you know, if you're trying to think of what you could write in your profile, I've given you some good examples of sort of profile quotes you could use. So things that we've found work really well with our clients are, you know, I like talking all about the things you're not supposed to discuss in polite company. That's a little bit naughty, but not sleazy. If you can eat a packet of Tim Tams in one sitting, we'll probably get along. And the last one's my favorite. Do not read the next sentence. You little rebel, I like you already. So these are just examples of little quotes you can use that are playful and funny if you don't want to be creative and come up with your own. But of course, I'd rather you come up with your own quotes because that shows a better part of your personality, and she may have seen these before. Now, there's something more you can do with your profile photo to get noticed, because what happens, I don't know if you've ever used Tinder, and it's easy to just go swipe, 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 swipe. You know, you get into a little bit of a cognitive rut where you're kind of in a trance looking at these Tinder photos. But actually, there's a really neat thing you can do, and that's called a pattern interrupt. So anytime you see a photo that has something in it that you didn't expect, that your brain doesn't expect to see, all of a sudden your attention goes to 100%, from 20% to 100%, and you look really closely to see what's going on. The first version of a pattern interrupt that I put in, and that's the version that was properly tested, was this one. And you'll see that it's a photo of me with a it's a match written below my face with a Tinder logo. And it sounds a little kitsch, but this really worked because instead of, when I did another test, I reset my profile again, swiped right to a random 100 women. Instead of getting 21, I got 34 matches. So that's an incredible boost in results. So the number of women who saw my profile and decided to swipe right to me. Now, I know that a number of you guys will say, well, that's fine, Damien. You seem to have some really good profile photos that you can use, but I've got nothing. I'm not a good looking guy at all. I don't have very many photos. I'm shy in photos. Photos don't look great on me. So I decided to see what I could do with a photo that was bad of myself and see if I could come up with a system whereby even if you had shitty photos, you could get a really great result. And I did. And here's what I did. So the first thing I did was I took a photo of myself that I knew women weren't gonna like. This one here, I shaved my head a few years ago. I was bored, I was going through a bit of a midlife crisis, and you can clearly see it's a hideous shot. And women agreed because no one swiped right to me. I had a 0% swipe right when I swiped 100 random women. So what did I do? Well, I got creative. I took a picture of myself and I took a picture of Bruce Willis and stuck him next to me in my profile photo. And then I wrote underneath, I'm Bruce Willis's evil twin. All of a sudden, I was getting matches. Now, I wasn't getting my 34% match rate, but I was getting 9 or 10 matches for every 100 swipes, which is still a pretty good result. And that was with a photo that no one liked. Women just hated that photo. So yeah, you don't need good photos to get a really good result. I'm gonna show you another example, something, a little trick that you can use in your Tinder profile. It takes a little bit of work, a little bit of creativity, but it works wonders. Now, this is something that one of my clients actually set up because we actually run an online Tinder training program where you teach you to get incredible results on Tinder, and I'll post a link down below. And one of my clients from that program built this profile. So what he did was he created a slideshow, and slideshows work really well. So what he put on the first image, his profile photo, is why you should swipe right, another Tinder PowerPoint. And then on his next slide, he has a bunch of photos, and it just says, I have friends and like to do things outside. His next slide says, things I like to do, and then look like my dad, play with puppies, take absolutely awful selfies. Now, you guys will notice there are no really good photos here. There's nothing particularly flattering in the photos of this man, but he's making it fun, he's making it playful. Then he says, things I'm good at, sleeping, filling a room with my laugh. Did I mention being a clone of my dad? Looking majestic. So he's having a little bit of fun at his own expense. Women do like that. Then he wrote reviews. You're my firstborn grandchild. I love you to pieces, grandma. Why the fuck are you asking me to review you, brother? You know, and so on and so forth. A fake review page. And then lastly, here's small picture of that puppy because I know you wanted it. And hint, pictures of dogs, cute animals, and puppies do wonders on your profile if you can find a way to sneak it in without making it look too obvious. They do absolute wonders, and that's why he did it. And you'll notice there were no good flattering photos of him. And yet he was getting, I think, a 19-20% match rate, even though there were no like high quality photos. So if you don't have the photos, you just got to get creative. You know, create a slideshow of yourself, introduce a little bit of humor, and you'll get an incredible match rate, because women, say what you want, but women do want a guy with a sense of humor. Women want a guy who's going to be fun to be around. And sure, not all women are going to see this guy, this client, and say, I like him, I want to date him. But enough do, and that's all that really matters. Being the hacker and the tester that I am, I trialed a whole bunch of different canned first liners that I could write to women to get the highest response rate possible. Because as many of you watchers know, it's one thing to match with a woman, it's another thing to get her to reply to you. Now, you're going to notice a theme, but you've always got to be funny. You've always got to be fun. Humor is a big part of it. If you make an interaction fun, you stand out from the crowd. So I started testing, and in fact, I even put into a spreadsheet here, you know, a bunch of one-liners that I could use, and measured the response rate on a lot of different profiles that I was testing it on. Now, so long as it was a humorous response, my lowest response rate was 60%. My average response rate was 77%. So to give you an example, a couple of like canned openers that I used on Tinder that worked really well. One of them was, wow, okay, so I just arrived on Tinder. I wasn't going to actually talk to anyone. In brackets, you could be an axe murderer after all. But I really liked X about your profile and had to say hello. So insert one thing about a profile that you like and say that that's why you wanted to say hello. Works really nicely. The other one I like is, so just checking, you aren't a fan of sharp, dangerous objects by any chance? In brackets, an impressionable young man can never be too careful. Both of these got a 75 to 80% response rate consistently. So they were really, really effective. But as always, you're better off coming up with messages yourself. So if you can look at a profile and think of something to tease women about, that's going to get an even higher percent conversion rate. And in fact, I was getting a 93% conversion rate on really good teasers I came up with on my own. Here are some examples. A girl next to probably her grandma. But what I wrote as a first message is, if you tell me that's your sister next to you in the photo, I am never skipping moisturizer day again. In another example, here's a profile of a woman. She says that she likes 2.5 men. So in my message to her, I wrote, you like 2.5 men, huh? I bet that's the same number of guys who foolishly walked into a poll while ogling you as you posed for your photo. So let's have a little look at the results that I got here. I managed to get a consistent 93% of women replying to my first message by making it fun. I could get a phone number from 72% of the women I talked to, and 61% of those would turn up to a date with me. Now, these aren't outrageous results. Many of my clients are getting the same results. Almost all of them are getting this, but slightly worse. Not by a lot, but that's just because they're not as practiced as I am. So what did this mean? This meant that my profile was able to get 32% of women to match with me. 93% of those women replied to my first message. 72% of those who replied agreed to give me their number. And of those who gave me their number, 61% actually came on a date with me. So that's 14 women for somewhere between 4 and 6 hours of total talking time. Now, you could never achieve those kind of results in a bar or club and not have sort of solid numbers that are going to turn out for the date. This is why I absolutely love Tinder. So the big takeaway, the big sort of way to get this kind of result is, you first of all, you've got to have a profile photo and a profile that getting these right is 70% of the battle. And if you get them right, you can just set and forget. You know, it's done, it's dusted. You're creating this amazing profile that's going to get you matches consistently. The second thing is, you've got to make women laugh. It's got to be humorous. And this is the most important element to getting her out on a date. If you're fun in your messages, if you're fun in your profile, if you're fun in the way you ask her out on a date, she's going to go with you. It's going to happen. You're going to stand up from the rest of the boring guys out there. And lastly, you want to message women when they're online and ask them out on a date at the end of the very first conversation. So don't wait too long to ask them out, to ask them for their number. Just do it. Like, have a short little chat and just ask, because most guys wait way too long and the ship has left. They've already made dates with other guys, so the opportunity is passed. Now, I want to let you guys know, I do run a whole training program called the School of Tinder online that you can register for right now by clicking below. Now, what we do in that program is a couple of things. First of all, there's an entire online training set of videos where I'm going to go through everything from how to get matches, how to get girls out on dates, how to create amazing dates, you know, how to screen women to know who's looking for just something fun and casual and who's looking for a relationship. Because I know for a lot of guys, it's difficult to know who wants a relationship and who's good to go. Well, how do you identify them? There's a whole process that I'm going to outline there for you. So it's a really comprehensive guide, but there's more than that. I'm also going to show you like real life examples, things you can write in your profile, a whole bunch of different quotes you can use, things you can use, a great quote you can use as an opening line, like hundreds of canned openers there, and also a lot of really playful, fun responses to a lot of the common questions women ask you. So you can literally be copying and pasting your way through a lot of your conversations on Tinder. You don't even have to think that hard and still be getting really incredible results. And lastly, guys, there's a dedicated Facebook group where myself and other coaches are actually resident, and you can post up your profile and we'll give you feedback. You can post up your conversations with women on Tinder and we'll give you live feedback on those profiles. That's going to ensure that you get the kind of results that I'm talking about here. So again, click on the link below to check that out. Now, guys, I hope you've enjoyed this video. If you reckon there's other tips that I could have included, let me know in the comments below. Give it a test. Did you get good results? Let me know in the comments below, guys. As always, I hope you enjoyed this video a bit longer than my normal ones. Go ahead and give me a thumbs up and subscribe if you haven't already. Take care, and I look forward to seeing you in my future videos.